with a new video and again a reading, healing, scan, all in one. I still have this, every time I do start a healing, I have this pain in my throat, like my glands are swollen and I can't swallow. Everything gets stuck here, and I know the medication you took in the past made you miserable, but maybe something new is on the market, and you also probably got used to this feeling. But for me, if I put myself in your body, which I did for a bit, don't worry, it hurts, it really hurts. And I would still be a bit worried about it. At least do a checkup every now and then or something. And maybe there is something else for you to make you feel better instead of worse. So it hurts. For me it hurts. As soon as I'm done with this video, I'll just ground myself. And but I can't solve that problem. I can't just take that lump out of your throat area and make it disappear magically. And I do think it has to do with something between hormones and taking the right nutrition. And I really want to have something, but I still can't find out what exactly it is. But something detoxing would be great. And if you, I can't force you to see a specialist or doctor or whatever, but if you don't do something about it, then maybe just look up some sites or Facebook groups that also work with holistic type of healing and herbal remedies and things like that. About your loneliness and not seeing yourself in this place nor that place. I think you left something of your soul behind when you left the country, or that something is still there. And in past lives, I don't see anything happen in Northern America or South America or Alaska or whatever. It's all Russia, Ukraine, Serbia, and the whole Russian continent and Europe still. But maybe you should just travel and enjoy bits and pieces of this country and that country. I know you have your responsibilities right now, but I do feel that life will be easier for you in the future. And the rhythm was really, really nice. Instead of doing this, it was up and down and up and down, and really nice. Again, beautiful dance. I bet you must be a great dancer, but I just can't make this happen. I don't know. I'm just this, la 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 la, and you are, whoa. So the rhythm is great. You are full of life, creativity, enthusiasm. It's just, there's something blocking you being able to express yourself as 100% you. And you keep calm by force, but I don't want you to explode because of your stacking emotions, and it piles up and it piles up, and then boom, something bad happens. So I try to make it soft and soothing, and this, I don't know. So your dance is great, something changed, that's a good thing. And the 8, instead of this, you went up and down, and really cool. Past lives, Russia, Ukraine, maybe you feel at home in Australia. I, for some odd reason, I think you never experienced a lifetime or a past life or a life in another dimension in Australia. So that might be interesting for you. But I know you have your responsibilities and you can't just pick up your stuff and leave, but the future will be easier, really. Then that wall, I decided to ask Ascended Master or Master Buddha to assist me in doing the healings, and you and him broke down this wall that split you up completely. It's gone. It just, you did some funny tapping movements or tapping sounds and against that wall, and it just disappeared. It was gone. So that's another good thing, because whatever I did wasn't working. And Buddha, I really like this guy. He's so gentle and so nice, and he's always smiley and kind. So when you feel angry or frustrated or aggravated or whatever, ask him to help you break down that wall silently, so you will be able to express your emotions and frustrations, not in a explosive way where you get angry and you start yelling and things like that, or you just run away from all the responsibilities that you have, but get through it soft and easy and gentle, and without putting on a mask of calmness and restriction and things like that. He will help you find abundance and joy. That's what he whispered in our ears. So and he give you a big hug, so I think you will be fine with Buddha. And not just abundance and joy, but also helps you with acceptance, forgiveness, and peace. Being content, being fine with where you are, who you are, who you're with. So that's a good thing, but it's a process that has to slowly activate these etheric layers that surround you. Another thing that came with the wall falling apart and breaking down was that there was a little girl, and I thought she was older, but she is smaller, and it is part of you. And the adult you and the child you took each other by the hand, and you just reconnected again. So for now, I think this is it. It was quite a bit of a job to do, but I put my intent in it, and I asked Buddha to guide you through your life in a way that makes you feel comfortable, forgiving, peaceful, full of joy, full of life, courageous also, all kinds of good things. And these energies surround you and infuse you, but it's not a process that is, it's triggered, but it has to slowly flow through you and into your life. Out of your eyes, it will just enter your crown chakra and flow through your eyes and flow through your hands and flow through your mouth and words and things like that. But that's a good thing. You won't be so divided or blocked or split up again anymore in the future. So if you by accident experience something like laughter for no reason at all, or tears for no reason at all, or nightmares that grew out of old frustration and anger, don't be surprised. It's just part of the clearing and part of the process to make you whole again. So that's it. See you next time. Bye.